Exodus 2. Here's the situation. Pharaoh just gave orders for his people, the Egyptians, to kill the firstborn baby boy of every Israelite in the land. And one of those women is about to have a baby boy. Oh no! But wait, that baby is Moses, and he's kind of important. Therefore, he's not allowed to die. Yet. Now, a man of the tribe of Levi married a Levite woman, and she became pregnant and gave birth to a son. When she saw that he was a fine child, she hid him for 3 months. But when she could hide him no longer, she got a papyrus basket for him and coated it with tar and pitch. Then she placed the child in it and put it among the reeds along the bank of the Nile. His sister stood at a distance to see what would happen to him. So she had a boy, then she realized the Egyptians would stab him if they ever saw him, so she hid him for 3 months. How? Babies poop. Babies cry. It's really hard to get away with no one noticing the stench for that long. But okay, 3 months later, she realizes someone might notice. So she puts the baby in a basket and leaves him by the river with his older sister watching over him. But you can't put a 3-month-old baby near open water. What are you doing? Just do whatever you were doing for the first 3 months and hope for the best. It can't be worse than whatever you're doing now. Then Pharaoh's daughter went down to the Nile to bathe, and her attendants were walking along the riverbank. She saw the basket among the reeds and sent her female slave to get it. She opened it and saw the baby. He was crying, and she felt sorry for him. "This is one of the Hebrew babies," she said. Oh my God, Ivanka is gonna murder the baby. Unless she realizes she hates her dad more than she loves following the rules, which is absolutely a thing daughters would do, so maybe there's hope. Then his sister asked Pharaoh's daughter, "Shall I go and get one of the Hebrew women to nurse the baby for you?" Wow. The baby's sister asked Pharaoh's daughter if she wants any help breastfeeding her new toy. Smart move. You can't say no to feeding a hungry, crying baby. "Yes, go," she answered. So the girl went and got the baby's mother. Pharaoh's daughter said to her, "Take this baby and nurse him for me, and I will pay you." So the woman took the baby and nursed him. When the child grew older, she took him to Pharaoh's daughter, and he became her son. She named him Moses, saying, "I drew him out of the water." Every mother hearing that passage has to be furious that someone just got paid to breastfeed her own baby. Life is so unfair. And what is up with that line about the child growing up and Pharaoh's daughter just taking him? He's not his mother's child anymore, just like that. And the daughter is acting like his savior when she and her family basically just kidnapped him. Notice that we never learn anything about Moses' childhood. He just grew older. We don't know who he was friends with, what he learned about, what his relationship with Pharaoh or his new mom was like. Nothing. The same thing will happen to Jesus later too. It's like the Bible's writers can't deal with adolescence, so they just skip ahead a few years. As for his name, it's kind of weird that the Egyptian Pharaoh's daughter named the boy Moses, which sounds like a Hebrew word meaning to draw out from water. Where would she have learned the language of the slaves? It's weird. For what it's worth, Moses is also similar to an Egyptian word meaning the one who is born. So I suppose that could also make sense, and then this section wouldn't be so weird. Except the Hebrew name origin makes way more sense. It just kind of ruins the story, though, because the people who knew those translations must have known something about it wasn't right. One day, after Moses had grown up, he went out to where his own people were and watched them at their hard labor. He saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his own people. Looking this way and that, and seeing no one, he killed the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. Did Moses just kill an Egyptian and hide the body? Because That's kind of badass. How did he kill the dude? Did he sneak up behind him and choke him out? Did he use an axe? I mean, this is a detail I would like to know. And where did he learn to do that? We know so little about his childhood. Apparently he went to ninja school. And why did he look this way and that? Obviously because he didn't want to be caught, but that suggests he knew it was wrong to kill. But how would he know that when God hasn't explicitly said so? Or maybe he was looking around to see if he could find an accomplice, trying to find a partner in crime. The next day, he went out and saw two Hebrews fighting. He asked the one in the wrong, "Why are you hitting your fellow Hebrew?" The man said, "Who made you ruler and judge over us? Are you thinking of killing me as you killed the Egyptian?" Then Moses was afraid and thought, "What I did must have become known." Moses is so screwed. They all know what he did. And instead of treating him like a hero because he killed one of their oppressors, they're mocking him for even questioning their behavior. How did they know, though? I thought Moses looked this way and that before murdering the guy. Who saw him do it? Bad ninja. When Pharaoh heard of this, he tried to kill Moses. But Moses fled from Pharaoh and went to live in Midian, where he sat down by a well. Now a priest of Midian had 7 daughters, and they came to draw water and fill the troughs to water their father's flock. Some shepherds came along and drove them away, but Moses got up and came to their rescue and watered their flock. The Bible is so universal. Whenever I fear for my life, I too run away to a new city, then become a hero for 7 single sisters. What is it with meeting women by the well? Abraham's servant found Rebecca by a well in Genesis 24, and she became Isaac's wife. Then Jacob met Rachel by a well in Genesis 29, and now this. Does no one go to a bar in this book? When the girls returned to Reuel, their father, he asked them, "Why have you returned so early today?" They answered, "An Egyptian rescued us from the shepherds. He even drew water for us and watered the flock." "And where is he?" Reuel asked his daughters. "Why did you leave him? Invite him to have something to eat." So Moses rescued their flock and gave them water, and then the girls just said, "Thanks, bye." Not even a tip? No one offering to marry him? That's unusual. Moses agreed to stay with the man who gave his daughter Zipporah to Moses in marriage. Zipporah gave birth to a son, and Moses named him Gershom, saying, "I have become a foreigner in a foreign land." Well, that was fast. Who knew giving water to an animal would lead to the birth of a son within a few sentences? But that last line is a classic. He's a stranger in a strange land. He's a Hebrew child who should have been killed, got adopted, or kidnapped, by Egyptian royalty, ran away after murdering a dude, and is now a new dad, totally out of place. Life comes at you fast after you go ninja on someone. During that long period, the king of Egypt died. The Israelites groaned in their slavery and cried out, and their cry for help because of their slavery went up to God. God heard their groaning, and he remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. So God looked on the Israelites and was concerned about them. So Pharaoh died, and the Israelite slaves cried, and God finally realized he was supposed to keep a promise? Why can't God remember this? God sounds like a husband who just forgot his anniversary. Like, it's today? I mean, of course it's today. I remember. I could never forget that. It won't happen again. Listen, I am so sorry for all the slavery. And what took the Israelites so long to cry out to God? They've been doing hard labor for years. You mean to tell me they never prayed while any of this was going on? It's not like God was doing anything else. Watching his creations is literally the only thing on his agenda. But I'm glad he finally found some concern. It's about time. I had no idea the first act of adult Moses was becoming a stone-cold killer. The Bible is full of surprises. I can't wait for Moses to get the Ten Commandments and realize one of them is thou shalt not kill. The look on his face is gonna be priceless.